Hi, my name is Leonardo Murillo, and I build cool stuff in AWS using products in AWS Marketplace. Thank you for joining me. We're going to be talking about industry trends, challenges, and how you can solve them. Today, I want us to talk about generative AI, large language models, and what they have meant to the stack that most organizations have to support today. Because over the past years, there's been a huge focus on trying to grab control of expanding complexity, right? The average system architecture today incorporates distributed services, multiple systems to store and query data, and basically an explosive combination of tools, all of which turns into growing cognitive load to teams. And there's been a trend towards decreasing that stack diversity and system complexity altogether. And platform engineering has surfaced, for example, to try and make sure that organizations are actually following some well-established patterns and that teams have access to proven tools and templates that they can easily deploy. And perhaps more importantly than that, that operations and cloud and security and basically everybody else that's involved, not just in making sure that stuff runs, but also that it stays running, they feel confident in it. And I think we've made solid strides in the right direction. I think containers have become the norm. Running them in Kubernetes is pretty much a standard. The cloud has come to remove a lot of the undifferentiated effort in keeping the lights on. And development tools, think for example, Visual Studio Code, right? They've pretty much landed on solid ground too. So where am I going with this? Machine learning is coming to disrupt this otherwise improving scenario of software engineering and system operations that we've built over the last few years. And not for no reason, because the stuff that you're now able to do with models that are basically readily available, you know, foundational models available off the shelf, and managed services such as Bedrock that gives you access to them with a couple of clicks, is resulting in yet again a growth in the complexity and diversity of our tech stacks. Think of RAG, for example, retrieval augmented generation, which is an incredibly efficient way to enrich the context that an LLM has with data without having to fine-tune or train a model. Every RAG implementation is going to require some form of vector storage. Vectors are the representations of data that you can use to basically search content given certain similarity, for instance, to what the LLM is generating. And with every pilot that's being built out there, one or more vector storage tools and solutions are added to the stack of organizations. So my question was, what if there was some vector storage that was already available in most organizations that we could just use? And this is coming from my own personal experience, because I'm pretty sure like most of you out there, I was trying my own version of an LLM prototype that was going to make me rich and revolutionize the world. And I was going through that exercise and I started trying all these different specialized databases that do vector data alone. And I was wasting so much time. I was wasting time familiarizing myself with the tool, getting the right developer tooling in place, learning how to use the developer tools. And I was spending more time doing all that than actually building my prototype. And then I stumbled into something that I did not anticipate. My good old and trusty Redis that I've used for many, many years as a key value store, pretty much, also supported vectors. And I was able to use all my existing tooling and I was able to interact with the same commands and use the same patterns that I had already grown so comfortable with over the years. And Redis that I picked in the past because how performing it was still satisfied the super fast responses that made me choose it as a solution for caching or queues or similar scenarios in the past. But the best part of it was that it introduced zero additional complexity to my tech stack. So here's two pieces of advice. If you need to store vectors, look into your existing tech stack because maybe there's something in there that already works and you don't have to bring in something new. And for the Redis users out there, which are pretty much everybody that I know, and you're looking for something flexible that does seemingly everything well, whether it's key value or now even the vectors, I really encourage you to give Redis a shot for your RAG implementation. And you can actually try it out just by looking Redis in AWS Marketplace or clicking the link that is in the article where you found this video. You can use it for free for a few weeks. And as part of this series, I'm going to release a hands-on lab to teach you how to actually do this step-by-step. So I hope I'll see you all soon. Thank you.